Gavin, of course, we've heard just moments ago. What do we know about the accident itself?
Yeah, well, we know it happened close to the airport at Pomona Road, the intersection of Pomona and the R21. And at this stage, it seems as if a truck had struck the car, which Gavin Watson was in. It was a huge accident, which caused quite a bit of delay in the area earlier on. And it seems as if he was the only fatality that happened during that car accident. Details very sketchy at the moment. We know that his family was on the way to the scene, and they've now proceeded to the mortuary. Other executives from Bosasa, known as African Global Operations, are also on their way to the scene, but at this stage the police and the emergency services are just trying to clarify exactly what happened before they released that statement.
Yeah, and of course when we think about Bosasa, we think about all of those allegations unfolding at the state capture inquiry, don't we?
We do indeed, and there are a number of allegations which Gavin Watson hasn't personally responded to in the public sphere, but we do know that he has appeared once before at the SARS inquiry into the tax affairs of African Global Operations. Of course, this inquiry was initiated after the testimony of former Bosasa Chief Operations Officer Angelo Agresi. And at that inquiry, Gavin Watson went on to explain some of the tax affairs, but the operations of Bosasa, saying that he was a member of the ANC. And of course, we have recently seen a letter where the ANC thanks Bosasa and Gavin Watson for a 3 million rand donation to their election campaign. So at this stage, still a number of allegations that he has to answer to.
You say that that was a closed event, his testimony there at the SARS inquiry. And I suppose one of the things we perhaps were looking forward to at the state capture inquiry was that he would be answering to some of the serious allegations that Angelo Agresi put forward.
Yeah, and that was a matter which the lawyers and investigators at the state capture inquiry were seized with. Now, we don't know how these events would affect their plan of action, because, of course, they had never clarified whether they intended to subpoena Gavin Watson to answer these. But he was a person who lived a quite reclusive life, and even when these allegations were made by Angelo Agresi, there was no public campaign to clarify whether or not they were true. So at this stage, we're hoping for more information from the police, but it's not forthcoming as yet.
You talk about living a very reclusive life. We hardly ever saw him out in public, but we did see him at one stage emerging from one of the premises of African Global Operations, the company that we know as Bosasa. His employees describing him as someone who was quite religious, would open up the day's work with prayer, would stop in the middle of the day to have prayer meetings. What else do we know about Gavin Watson, the man?
Well, there was also a claim by Angelo Agresi that Watson didn't want to sign any paperwork himself, that he would often delegate that power and hand over his power of attorney to some of the other colleagues or executives at Bosasa to take care of operations. But we also do know that his family was one which was close to the ANC during the apartheid years, specifically related to sports in the Eastern Cape, where the Watson family played a prominent role in trying to cultivate black rugby talent. But in terms of his donations to the ANC, they seem to have been something which had happened over the years, not only during President Jacob Zuma's administration. So he was known as an ANC benefactor, him and other members of his family. Whether or not the allegations that he used his influence within the ANC to secure government tenders and Angelo Agresi's flat-out accusation that he bribed former President Jacob Zuma were true at this stage has not been tested. And the former president has said that Agresi was just speculating about things that he may have heard. So a denial from the former president. That allegation, of course, not tested yet.
Yeah. All right. Well, thanks very much for coming into studio. Gavin Whittles will be tracking this story for us very closely. It's news that, rather shocking news that's just come to us within the hour. Bosasa head Gavin Watson being killed in a car accident somewhere near the airport, we are told. And of course, he's the CEO of the company known now known as African Global Operations, the company widely implicated in corruption at the state capture inquiry.